objective of the PM ASHA. So in objective, why government is emphasis and why the this side Sindhu, and today we will discuss the PM ASHA. As you know that recently cabinet has approved some huge amount for the PM ASHA scheme. So today, in today's discussion, we will see that why the PM ASHA is important and what is the main component of PM ASHA and how it will help help the people. Okay, so as you know that PM ASHA stand for Pradhan Mantri Ann Data Aay Sanrakshan Yojana. So as you know that our country almost 55% people depend on the agriculture. So the schemes, everything that is related to the farmers, that is very important as the point of view of examinations and also the point of view of the employment and economy, because a large number of peoples depend on the agriculture sectors and a lot of people gain employment from the sectors. So now we will see that Pradhan Mantri, as you know that Pradhan Mantri Ann Data Aay Sanrakshan Abhiyan PM ASHA is not a new scheme. It's currently celebrating its 6th anniversary, because it's already, it has been started since the 2018. Okay, but what is new here, that government cabinet recently approved budget of 35,000 crore for the PM ASHA scheme to revamp the scheme so that it will help the farmer. So now we will see that what is the PM ASHA scheme and what's your what's the component of PM ASHA. So PM ASHA scheme is a Pradhan Mantri Ann Data Aay Sanrakshan Abhiyan. That is an umbrella scheme. Okay, so umbrella scheme means a lot of scheme is in the scheme, okay, under the schemes, and it is especially designed for the fair prices. Okay, so as you know that our government provide a lot of MSP for the different crops, okay, but here also it is also the form of MSP only to the farmer, to the support to the farmer, but for the special crops like pulses and oil seed and copra. So these are the three things that are included in the PM ASHA. So these things get the MSP for the, and now we will see the objective of the PM ASHA scheme. Objective of the PM ASHA. So in objective, why government is emphasis and why the a large huge amount of the budget allocated to the scheme, because here the objective to give a remunerative price to the farmer, okay, so protect the farmer from the distress sale. So as you know that as the when the crop in the crop seasons, if the production is very high, then production is very high, then the demand of the food prices goes down. Okay, so that's why sometimes in distress, all the farmers don't have a storage capacity and everything, so that they can preserve their their crop and sell at the fair prices. So that's why in distress, they sell their product whatever price they are getting in the markets. So that's why it's necessary for government to intervene here and give it a shot to save the farmer. Okay, so remunerative price. protect farmers here. How farmer is protected? So from distress sales, they will get protected from the from and get a fair prices. Self sufficiency. As you know that every now and then we see that pulses price is too high every time, and also the oil seed. We consume a lot of oil and pulses. As you know that in every food we have try to include the pulses in the oil, but here the lack of productions, prices are always high, and this cost the consumer also, and a lot of distress to the farmer as well and the consumer as well. That's why it's necessary to become a self-sufficiency so that we can reduce the food inflations and increase income and protect the consumer. So here aim is also objective of the government also to protect the farmer income, protect the farmer and also increase the farmer income and also protect the consumer. As you know that as prices goes up, a lot of people suffer from that. A lot of people who are not very sufficient in getting their basic necessities, so they also suffer a lot due to the increase of pulses, because pulses is a main source of protein for everybody. But if their prices goes up, the consumer suffers, and also oil. As you know, we consume a lot of street food and everything that is main ingredient is oil. So that's why it's necessary to protect the consumer as well. Now we will see the component of the PM ASA scheme. So first is a price support scheme. Okay, price support scheme, what government does, government physically procure the pulses, oil seed and copra. Okay, so here the directly by the government agency, as you know that like FCI and all the agricultural agency, they directly procure the food grain from the farmers. Okay, state government procure directly. And next is a price deficiency payment scheme. So here what government does, here in this scheme does not involve any physical procurement of crops. Okay, here farmers, government does not procure directly from the farmers. What instead of that, what government does, government allow the farmer to sell their product in the mandi and the market anywhere, and whatever difference between the MSP price and the market price, that government directly pay to the farmer in their bank accounts. So this is also feasible for the government, because as we know that there is a lack of infrastructure in our country, so it's not feasible for government to always procure. So that's why it's necessary to protect the farmer, and this has been done. See, there is one more thing here, private procurement. This scheme is discontinued now, as of now, but that was a pilot project government has started, that as private player will procure the things from the government, from the farmers, and government will pay to the private player, but it has been discontinued. So now as we know that currently as government has improved the schemes and pumped a lot of money, so now the component will be price support scheme, price stabilization fund, and PDPS, price deficiency payment, and market intervention scheme. So through the market intervention, government will protect the farmer as well, and also protect the consumer, and also the country as we will become the self-sufficient in the production of oil and pulses. So now the new schemes will aims to provide fair prices plus stabilize essential commodity prices for the consumer. So this is about the schemes, and now it's in news. So it's your responsibility to prepare a holistic notes on the scheme. As you know that scheme are very important from the point of view of examinations, and this scheme is also important. So make your notes and be prepared. Thank you.